This presentation is designed to help explain the real value of power modules. We will take a detailed look at one of the aspects related to power module design and reliability, which is inductor withstand voltage. What is inductor withstand voltage? Very simply, it is a dielectric breakdown. Why does this particular inductor characteristic matter? It matters because the market is continuously requesting products that operate at higher input voltages, and those higher voltages may impact the reliability of the components within our power modules. The withstand voltage of an inductor is the maximum voltage that can be applied to its terminals without causing dielectric breakdown. Dielectric breakdown can occur in the wire insulation or the iron particle insulation of the inductor. When it occurs, the inductor is damaged, and depending on the power supply protection modes, the inductor can fail catastrophically. So it is very important to understand the voltage limitations of an inductor. Now, we know that inductors are not meant to handle DC voltages. So to be clear, we are talking about the instantaneous voltage across the terminals of the inductor. For example, in a buck power supply topology, when the high side FET is on, the inductor sees a potential equal to Vin minus Vout. That voltage must never exceed the inductor withstand voltage. In addition, various system conditions should be considered when determining the worst case voltage the inductor might see. For example, a buck power supply operating at a max Vin with a shorted output is typically the worst case voltage stress for the inductor. This topic is important because the market is asking for devices with higher input voltage ratings. Some of our embedded modules operate up to 17 volts input. Our newest embedded modules operate up to 36 volts input, and we are seeing requests for 65 volt input devices and even higher. The chip inductors used in these modules have good performance and very small size. However, there is a limit to their withstand voltage capability, and this performance does vary from one vendor to the next. Most inductor manufacturers use an impulse winding tester to guarantee each inductor exceeds its specified withstand voltage. The tester applies a pulsed excitation to the device and analyzes the resonant response for area size and Laplacian values. From this data, the inductor's withstand voltage can be determined as pass or fail. Most inductor vendors do not publish the withstand voltage capability of their inductors. Therefore, TI uses an impulse tester to perform component level characterization of all our inductors to be used within our power modules in order to guarantee reliable operation at high input voltages. TI is presently working with its inductor suppliers to specify and improve the working voltage of various inductors and to ensure that there is sufficient voltage margin for the inductor in the module application. Here is an example showing the inductor voltage breakdown of a few samples. The mean failure occurred at 166 volts with a standard deviation of 41 volts. A 3 sigma limit would rate this inductor for 44 volts. The inductor vendor specified this device for 40 volt operation. This presentation has showed some of the value that a power module brings. Specifically, TI puts a lot of effort into qualifying and selecting the right components to ensure we are providing reliable products to our power module customers. Power modules bring value in other ways as well. They are simple and easy to use. They are able to achieve high power density, oftentimes even higher than discrete solutions. They enable fast time to market, and in addition, power modules are fully characterized for electrical, thermal, and EMI performance. When it comes to power module design, TI sweats the details. For more information, please visit ti.com/powermodules.